Have you been looking for a video where you want to know what to put in a hospital bag, but you're actually having a C-section and all of them are for vaginal deliveries? If so, I'm going to show you, as a second time C-section mom, exactly what is in my C-section hospital bag. If you're new here, hello, welcome. My name is Jenny. I am a teacher, a mom of a one-year-old named Alice, and also a doctoral student expecting baby number two sometime in July. So right now I'm in my third trimester. And since I have a history of preterm labor, I went ahead and started kind of doing a preliminary packing of my hospital bag. So this is the stuff that I feel like is necessary, that I felt like I had to have in order to be ready to go. So let's dig in and I'll show you what's in here. So the first thing that's in here is a pair of comfortable slippers. You are definitely going to need some sort of slippers. You can get fuzzy ones like these. I got these at Target and they say Mama Bear on them. So you can get a pair of fuzzy slippers or you can get a pair of flip-flops, but you're definitely gonna need something to put on your feet. Since I'm delivering in the summertime, I think I might regret these fuzzy slippers, but either way, I wanted to have some comfortable slippers because you are gonna be shuffling around, especially after a C-section. Having something cushy to walk on will be really nice when you're trying to walk those halls because you get better a lot faster when you walk. The next thing that I put in my bag, and I highly recommend that you put something like this in here, is a nursing nightgown. Now, the reason I have a nightgown is because you do not want to have, and it's just like a V-neck nightgown, that's all it is. It's this purple nightgown, I got it off of Amazon. You want something a little oversized because after you have your surgery, that area around where your incision is very tender, and wearing pants or leggings or something like that, a nice little pajama set, that's going to be very uncomfortable. So if you're not going to go for loose fitting pants, really, really loose fitting pants, I really like having the nursing nightgown. I wore it with my first pregnancy and I really was glad that I had it. The next necessity for me is actually, I brought two of them because I'm not sure which one is gonna work best for me. Some sort of nursing or pumping bra. Now with my first baby, she went to the NICU and I wound up having to pump. And I really regretted not having a pumping bra in my bag. Now my hope is that I can actually nurse, so I am packing a nursing bra in here as well. But I also wanted to make sure I had a pumping bra. So I have this, just this basic one that I got from Target that I have here. It's just a basic pumping bra, really light. You're gonna want something that's probably oversized. Again, good support, but not something too tight because you're gonna wind up with clogs if you have something too tight. And then this is my favorite bra brand for nursing and pumping, which is Kindred Bravely. They're very comfortable. So this is another bra that I put in the bag here for me to wear. Honestly, I'll probably wear this and the nursing nightgown, or maybe just the nursing nightgown, for most of the time that I'm in the hospital. Speaking of nursing, one thing that's a little large that I'm gonna throw in my trunk to be ready to have that I didn't have before is a nursing pillow. I used this with my daughter Alice. This is the My Breast Friend nursing pillow. It kind of like snaps around your back here. I used this with my daughter Alice and I did not have it at the hospital because like I said, my baby being in the NICU, I couldn't breastfeed her. But this time I'd really like to try, so I'm fingers crossed hoping that I don't wind up going into preterm labor again. So I want to bring this pillow and see if it helps out with breastfeeding because I really use this a lot once Alice finally got how to breastfeed at home. So I will be bringing this with me to the hospital. The next thing you're gonna need is a coming home outfit. So I just have this basic dress. Again, like I said, I like to bring stuff that is not fitted around your incision area at all. So this is just a maxi dress and I got this on Amazon. Literally just a maxi dress with a skirt part here. Really loose fitting. Comfortable, lightweight because it's going to be the summertime, but just basic maxi dress for me to wear on the way home because again, that C-section incision is tender. It doesn't necessarily, it's not terrible, but I wouldn't wear anything that's going to rub on it. So that's why most of the stuff that I'm bringing is going to be loose fitting or things like dresses that don't have any sort of pressure on that C-section scar because it's pretty tender after you have your surgery. So I mentioned loose fitting pants. These are actually the pants that I wore for my C-section for my first daughter. And I'm gonna bring them again because they were very comfortable and they're super loose. They're basically just really loose, large pajama pants, yoga pants, and they came all the way up to kind of like my waistline. And I liked that because it meant that there was no pressure on my scar. Your scar is gonna sit basically right below where your baby bump is, at the top of your underwear line. So you don't want anything that's gonna be sitting there because it's going to be very uncomfortable. So I did bring a pair of pants just in case the hospital is cold. I doubt it because it's going to be July and I tend to like things pretty cold, but I did bring a pair of pants just in case I want them to go with it. I also have a second nursing nightgown shirt because being in a C-section, you're probably going to be staying in the hospital for more than one night, so you might want to change your clothes. However, I know there's some people that wind up only staying there for two nights, and then you really might not need two, but I'm only going to bring two tops, these two tops. They're the literal exact same top. They're really comfortable, oversized, and I know that they're comfortable for C-sections. I'll put a picture of what it looks like on Amazon right here, and I will put a link down in the description if you want to get the same one. I really like these. These are very comfortable, and I wore them a lot when I was home with my daughter as well. The next thing might seem a little bit silly, but I really was glad that I had it, and that's just an eye mask. So I just had a basic eye mask. People come in and out of your room all the time, and I really liked having an eye mask. I'm a light sleeper, so I needed that eye mask, and I was so glad to have it because there's all sorts of stuff that's on and beeping, and you really can't get your room that dark because the nurses are coming in and out all the time. So having an eye mask to help you sleep even for an hour is a godsend. So I would recommend, if you happen to have an eye mask at home, it's very helpful to have to help you sleep. Something else that you've seen probably on a lot of these videos about what's in a hospital bag are these mesh underwear that you can get, and I am gonna bring two of them. So these are the Always Discreet Boutique ones. I like these a lot because of the fact that the pad is built in. So when you have a C-section, the pad's built in here. When you have a C-section, you do bleed, and you will have to wear either something like this or the mesh underwear that they give you at the hospital. The pro of the mesh underwear that they give you at the hospital is it's very loose fitting. It doesn't hurt over your C-section scar generally. However, the annoying part about it is that the pad is separate. So you have a pad in there and you have the underwear. So when you're really tender and you're going to sit down to go to the bathroom, it can really be a pain in the butt to pull down and pull up the mesh underwear and make sure the pad stays in place because it's a big pad. So I say the perk of this one is the fact that the pad is built in, so you only have to worry about pulling this up and down. So I will be bringing two of these. I didn't bleed a ton with my first pregnancy, but I did bleed, so I wanted to bring two pairs of these. And then if I need more, then I'll use the ones at the hospital that are mesh. I didn't like these my first time around because I found that the fabric at the top would get stuck on my incision site because of the fact that it still had the adhesive from the bandages. Basically, you take a shower, your bandages will come off, you'll take them off, they'll ask you to take them off. But every hospital's different, yours might be different. But my hospital said, okay, go take a shower, your bandages will come off. So my bandages came off, but the adhesive did not. So this would get stuck, which meant that I was pulling underwear down over my incision, over the adhesive, every time I went to the bathroom, which after you have a C-section, that's just one extra thing to really irritate you. And so when I talked to my doctor the day after when he came to check on me, I was like, look, this is, I can't get this adhesive off. What can I do? And he was like, try Goo Gone. And I thought, huh, that's really weird, but okay, I'll try it. It came off like that. So believe it or not, in my hospital bag, I actually have bandage and adhesive remover Goo Gone because for me, it was very painful to have to pull up the mesh underwear and this underwear over an incision site that was sticky, and I couldn't get it off with regular soap and water. And I'm gonna be honest, when you are post C-section, you're not gonna wanna be scrubbing really hard to try to get it off. So this, just with a cotton ball, works wonders. I highly recommend getting some of this if you can, if you have the same issue or you know that you're gonna have bandages that you're gonna be taking off at the hospital. This was so helpful, and I'm really glad that they have it specifically for adhesive too, bandages and adhesive, so you know that this is skin safe as well. Okay, so let's talk about toiletries. Toiletries are kind of basic and universal, so whatever it is that you specifically need is probably what you wanna bring, but I'll show you what it is that I'm bringing. So I am bringing some shampoo and conditioner because, like I said, they do have you take a shower to get the bandages off, at least at my hospital, because you have to soak them really, really, really well, so then it's easy to pull off the bandages. So I actually literally have these little Disney Resort samples that I'm gonna bring. That's just shampoo, conditioner, and body wash. So I'll be using these three. And then I also have a toothbrush, of course. You need a toothbrush because you're gonna be there for a little while. And then I have my tiny little toiletries bag here, and I'll show you what I have in it. Like I said, I don't bring a whole ton of stuff because there's just not a lot that you need. I have some cleanser for my face if I decide that I want to do that. I have some dry shampoo. This I probably will use if I feel like I'm looking a mess. I have a tiny deodorant. You should definitely have some deodorant. You're gonna want deodorant regardless of where you're going. I have some chapstick. Very, very important to have chapstick. You're gonna be there for a while. The room could be cold. Definitely have some chapstick. I have a tiny brush, and with the tiny brush, I actually have two hair ties. And I actually wore my hair in double pigtails. It was much easier for me to do that. So I'll put a picture right here of me with my double pigtails after my last C-section. I found it was very helpful to have my hair up or braided or something. So I would recommend you bring some hair ties to keep in your bag if you have long hair like I do. I have a miniature toothpaste, of course, to go with my toothbrush. There are some things that people might put in their bag that I just feel like the hospital supplies for you. So I don't bring any extra stuff. The mesh underwear is just fine. They give you pads, they give you wipes, they give you diapers, they give you all sorts of different creams and ointments. Most other things you really don't need. They give you so much stuff. So this is just kind of like my basic C-section recovery kit. Now, one other thing I will be bringing to the hospital that I haven't bought yet is snacks. Depending on when your C-section is, obviously you cannot eat before your C-section because there's a chance that you could actually get sick after your C-section. So definitely follow your doctor's rules about when you can and cannot eat. However, what happened with me, I had my C-section at around 4:30 p.m. and then by the time I got to my room, it was around 6:30 p.m. So I missed dinner entirely and I didn't get to eat, and I was so sad because I basically was starving all night telling the nurses, like, please, can I have some food? And they're like, there's nothing we could do. The cafeteria is already closed. So I will be bringing some snacks. So something to keep in mind, you might want to just toss like one or two snacks in here. Is there anything that you're bringing for your C-section that's different than me? I would love to know. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. I post new content every week, especially about my pregnancy. Thanks so much, and I will see you next time. Take care.